Okay, so regular inside one, vertical, right? We come here, right?
Yeah.
What I found is, don't swing through, but this really works best when you're super, super close, right? We work in middle range because it's safe and we don't want to hurt each other, so we're hitting sticks, not hands, right? It's essentially for the essence, it's for the drill, so that we won't get hurt. Learn to work a good check hand, right? Learn to work the rest of the techniques that you're doing, right? But in real life, the guy doesn't stop. When he goes to hit me, he doesn't stop. He's gonna go through just like that. So what I figured was, my chance of him in real time of going here, and as it's still moving to here, at least me, in my experience, I kept getting hit. If I didn't get hit, back up. If I didn't already get hit here, because my hand's out, then I got hit trying to do the check hand. And I don't really like getting hit in the hand, or anywhere else, quite honestly. So, knowing, thinking about our supposed blend, Serrato, Largamano, Decortis, right? And knowing that Decortis, not that I was searching for Decortis, but you gotta try to pull what you can out of the crap that you got. I think, okay, well, D's got reinforced blocks. I kept remembering, but if I got that many ways you can reinforce this. So I started experimenting with reinforcing it like this, and what I found out is that I still got hit in the hand sometimes there. But that's not good either. But one time, the strike came a little bit vertical, I missed, and it went like that. And I almost those two fingers went, yeah. And that wasn't fun. Especially if it did that would have really sucked, like broken in the middle. So what I figured is, okay, well, that's not gonna work, so... Oh, and one time I did block it, but the stick kind of came back like this, and it did this to my hand, because my hand wasn't closed. That didn't feel good either. Like, okay, well, what am I doing? This isn't good, and this isn't good for me, and I don't want to keep it out, so I came up with, boom, keeping it closed. And I said, instead of putting it on the bone, I put it right there in the meat of the hand, so it's nice and cushioned. So I make a nice, good karate fist and put it right on that. So now I've got this, but I'm also reinforced here. So it's not just this in a possible hook. I've got this fighting my grip, and I'm anchored on my body. So I'm anchored, and so this pushes in here, and then this holds. So now when he swings through, right, I go, ooh, here, see? I get my body out of the way, like, even from there, can make sure you hit me. See, he can technically hit me, right? So he goes, right? Ooh, get my body out of the way and put this in front of me. I'm not blocking, I'm just defending. It's more, that to me is a deflection. I'm absorbing the blow with the stick in my body, partially, but not actually blocking. A block, to me, at least dictionary definition, denotes an actual stop. So instead of blocking, I'm defending. Oh, shit. Okay, now at this point, put it back up. Okay, it goes through. I'm now technically on the outside, so now this is when I move. Now, for us, our outside one, you know, comes here, right? Here, here. Well, I'm already passed, so I just need to be here. The next thing he's going to give me, the way he said, is either going to be a two or four, some kind of backhand. I know that because you can't really do anything else. So knowing that, I'm here, I can, well, what I do, since I'm here, I do a quick hit. Not a kill shot, and it might not even be a guarantee that I even hit him, but at least gives me a chance. I can pop, it'll then hopefully slow that down. Even if it doesn't, it puts me in the motion to do this, our outside vertical, from here, and then we can finish, right? If he's super fast, okay, here and there, see? That move gives me this ability. I can use this and make it a hit. So maybe I don't hit there, but that keeps coming, and I can end up here. Okay, now from there I'm on the inside. Again, we can go back to our Serrato drill. Okay, if we were gonna do it, okay, so see here, see? Then I can, okay, and then I can go back to my drill. Or I can just grind a hit, or just hit. Just go for it. So that's kind of how I got to that. For the two, kind of same thing. Here. Oh, now one other thing too. You can want to get, I don't want to be on the inside too much, because, okay, this will work. Okay, go ahead and do it. But I have to back the hell out of the way, because what happens is, and I got a scar right there to show, that's actually a blade I was testing one day a long time ago. What happened was, I went too far in, and that, then bam, I got hit, right? So, okay, I remember, and Master Tino and Professor Elliot all talking about stepping wrong. So instead of stepping right and possibly putting myself by accident doing this too much, and number two, if I back up, I don't have a whole lot here. I'm doing this, which structurally isn't all that great. So if I step left instead, okay, what I've got is I've got my power forward now. I've got my defense, my shield on my left side, not on my right, on my left side. So my left is forward, leg now is, I'm angled on my right side, so I've got stability. So now look, I can lean back, kind of a like a short elastico, right? I've got plenty of room. So now, okay, so now I do it. So now, yeah, see, now I can hold myself back, right? I still put my guard up, and I'm protected here. Now from here, I'm left leg out. Well, as you see, that everyone always says, if you're on the left, right? So if you're on the left, have your left leg out. I'm on the left, so here I am. I'm ready to go. Okay. On a two, I just do the exact opposite. Instead of the light, instead of coming here, and possibly getting hit, or doing this and not having the hole back here, right? I just step right. Again. Oop, I missed. Is that coming? Swing. That's right. Good. All right, ready? There, see? So I've got my left leg behind me now, so I've got sort of this elastico get the hell out of the way move. I'm anchored. Just like we do outside. Go, hold it out. Just like we do here to here. Outside. On a two. Outside vertical, right? Or give me a one. All right, if we're going this, but here. This move to here. All right? Basically, with my stick, I anchor it here, and I'm here. So, knowing that, here, boom, it goes through. Now, quick left tap. If the three or another one comes, I now have the time to use my check hand. I can then key, you know, I can continue the drill, or I can just fucking wail away, or if that three comes, right, I can then start blending, okay, and finish them. So that's kind of how, that's kind of where I came up with that. On a number three, same as a number one, just low. I just drop down more. I still got the same leg. I'm still getting the hell out of the way. So go ahead and swing. Here. Sure. See? And again, back up. By that time I hit low. It's the same as one, just lower. On a four, same thing. Same exact thing. Boom. Same thing. Boom. Okay. Boom. Boom. Whatever. I can finish however I want. From here, I can just do that. Doesn't matter. Five, a little different because of the thrust. Okay. But instead of just trying to get out of the way and possibly getting hit, right? Instead of just abanicoing and possibly missing, I put them both together here. Okay. Now I keep my abanico vertical instead of going all the way. I was taught come and then hit and then back. Instead, I figure, okay, if he's committed to the five and I keep my stick vertical, if that's a blade, he's got. If it's stick, that still hurts. I can hit that way. Number two, from here to here, I actually have more strength there, because if he comes in with a four, I can feel that and I can pass it if I want to. If I'm already here and it goes for a four, I may miss, because I'm essentially leaving him an opening, right? So, he comes in, boom, here, see? I keep it vertical, okay? I can then do my outside one, or if he's going to come in, so assuming he's skilled, he's going to come in there, I can finish off. On the inside, same thing, okay? Keeping it vertical, okay? Now, assuming that didn't do anything, his next move is more than likely going to be three, so I'll just pass it. I got tagged a little bit there, but a tag there is negligible compared to what could be. Okay, so, going to do the three, here, see? And that time, I used my left leg out. Because when I pass, my right leg, which was in the way earlier, is now no longer in the way. Now from here, if that's a knife, he's already getting cut. And now he's going to get cut again. If it's a stick, I get hit, just right there, just pow, take him. Again, not a kill shot, but if I got hit there, does this. See, then you can, or I go here, that's a liver shot, okay? And I get hit here, that takes him down, and then, again, I can finish. I can finish him. So that's kind of the direction I was going.